Hello everyone, welcome to this session. In this session we can take a look the introduction to Spring integration. Before we take a look of what is Spring integration, let's discuss the real-time application, real-time environment. So we all are live in a event-driven world. Through the each of day we are continuously bombarded by phone calls, emails and instant messages. So let's turn our attention the same stuff we also do in we are getting in our software side. So let's turn our attention to software. When we design and build a software application, we strive to provide a foundation that accurately models the application domain. For example, consider an online travel booking application. When you plan a trip by booking a flight, hotel and rental a car, you don't typically sit and wait the computer for all of the trip details. You may receive a confirmation number for the trip itself and high level summary of the various reservation, but the full details will arrive later. So you may receive an email telling you to log in and review the details. In other words, even though the application may be described as a service, it's likely implemented as an event driven system. There are too many different services are involved to wrap the whole thing in a single synchronous action as a traditional client server. So your request is likely processed by series of events, messages being passed across a range of participating systems. So when we are designing a software, it's often useful to consider the events and messages that occur within the domain at the end. So we are going to focusing on event and message rather than being excessively service oriented may lead to more natural way to think about the problem in this session. So the Spring integration addresses these challenges. It's aimed to increase the productivity, simplify the development, provide a solid platform from which you can tackle the complexities. It also offers a lightweight, non-invasive and declarative model for constructing message-driven application. Spring integration stands for the shoulders of two giants, Spring Framework and Enterprise Integration Pattern. It also known as a EIP. So let's take a look of the architecture of Spring integration. So Spring integration consists two parts. Particular both are focusing on lightweight and intra-application messaging and inter-application integration. So the what is lightweight intra-application messaging? Then it is a core. It's messaging framework that supports lightweight event-driven interaction within an application. On top of that core, it provides an adapter based platform that supports flexible integration of applications across the enterprise. Everything deprecated in the core messaging area of the figure would exist within the scope of single Spring application context. Those components would exchange messages in a lightweight manner because they are running in the same instance of Java virtual machine. There is no need to worry about serialization and unless necessary for a particular component. The message content doesn't need to be represented in XML. Instead of most messages will contain a plain old Java object called Pojo also instances as their payloads. And what is inter-application integration? So the inter-application integration is a different. There are various adapters are used to map the content from outbound messages into the format and some external system expect to receive and to map inbound content from those external system to message. The way mapping is implemented depends on the particular adapter, but the Spring integration provides a consistent model that is easy to extend. The Spring integration 2.0 distribution includes the support for the following adapters, like it supports the file system, FTP, SFTP, user datagram protocol, then TCP, HTTP, the SOAP web service, mail integration, GMS, GMX, remote method invocation, Twitter chatting, and extensible messaging and presence protocol. So if you can see, this is the JVM. It's a pretty straightforward architecture of Spring integration compared to the another framework architecture. The core messaging and application integration. So application integration just call and use that.